Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to the KFC series. We are super, super close at this point. I'm thinking this one is really honing in on that final recipe. And the final recipe is sort of a group effort. We started out looking at a bunch of different recipes that people had presented over the years as being copycat recipes or leaked recipes. Some of those we discounted right away, like there's one from the Chicago Tribune right away. Wasn't right, wasn't even close. We talked to a lot of people who have been in the orbit of KFC over the years, who have worked for the Colonel. We've talked to people on the KFC boards who are working tirelessly to figure out what the formula is. And I'm putting that together with my own experience of making television commercials for KFC. And over about a 20-year period, shooting a number of these TV commercials, being on set, working with people from KFC, looking at what they were doing, how the process changed, how the ingredients changed, how the methods changed. And I've sort of put all of that together and has brought us to this recipe. So this is sort of fine-tuning all of the things that we thought were really good, and I've put them together in amounts that I think are going to work. So let's get right into putting this spice blend together. So first into my little grinder, star anise, coriander seed, ground garlic, rosemary, and marjoram. Now, there's a lot of people in the comment section saying that there's no way that the Colonel spice mix could have coriander because they're sensitive to coriander and it tastes like soap to them. Totally get where you're coming from. Here's the deal. That soap flavor is imparted by the fresh leaf of the coriander plant that is usually called cilantro. The seed doesn't contain the volatile compounds that are going to give you that soapy taste. So the reality is you are probably eating coriander seed all the time and you don't know it. Or you're saying, no, I don't want any coriander seed because it tastes bad to me, and you're missing out on something that is very flavorful and you would probably love. Next in is clove, another really sort of divisive spice in this mix. A lot of people saying that there can't be any clove because it contains something called eugenol. Probably not saying that correctly. And that flavor shouldn't be there. Other people saying that they are allergic to clove, which could possibly be, but if you're allergic to clove, the compound in clove that you're allergic to is also in several of the other spices in this mix that no one disputes, like pepper. So perhaps you're not allergic to clove. Just putting it out there. Next in is sage. No one disputes that. After that is ginger. Summer savory, which is an herb that a lot of people don't know exists or don't know what it is or they've never seen it. Very popular here in Canada, and it grows wild through parts of eastern Canada. And it is definitely one of the things that Colonel Sanders said over and over and over, there's savory in the mix. Next in is red pepper. Not too much, just enough. Now we move on to fine flake salt. This, I'm only putting in a little bit. The rest of the salt will go into the flour mixture. This amount of salt is just in there to kind of stabilize everything else. The big one, MSG. Definitely MSG. And when we get to the flouring, I'm going to talk about two other compounds that I believe should be in here that aren't because I can't get my hands on them right now because of COVID. So we move on to white pepper. Definitely white pepper. That is the overarchingly dominant note in this mix. And finally, black pepper. And this is telecherry black pepper. Over and over and over and over and over, people say in the comments, oh, you need telecherry, you need telecherry. Now, telecherry black pepper is, from a botanical standpoint, exactly the same as every other black pepper that's grown around the world. This one is just grown in a very specific part of India. And my understanding is that they let it stay on the tree longer before they pick it. And there's a couple of other things that they do to it. It has a distinct smell from regular black pepper. So it could make a big difference. Now, put that in, give it a shake, and there is the spice mix. So it'll only be a couple of seconds for you. I'm gonna reset and we'll start breading and frying some chicken. Okay, so we're gonna take the spice mix that we just made and we're gonna do the chicken four different ways. The first way we're gonna do the chicken is like this. And so this is flour. I put the spice mix in. The chicken is gonna get dipped in an egg wash. So this is milk and egg. That's sort of the OG recipe, the way that the Colonel was doing it in the 1950s. Then we're gonna do it this way. So in with the flour goes dried egg powder and dried milk powder, as well as the spice mix. And I'll mix that together. The chicken just gets a dunk in cold water before the breading, and the water is just to make the breading stick. Same with the milk and egg wash, although the milk and egg will add a little bit of flavor. Three and four, this is chicken that has been brined in a little bit of the spice mix to try to get that flavor into the chicken leg. And so I'm gonna do that brined chicken two ways. Some of it's going to get dunked into the egg wash and then breaded, and some of it's going to get dunked into the water wash and then breaded. Then it's all gonna get deep fried and we'll do a giant taste test and see where we're at. And hopefully this sort of hones us right into where we need to be. So let's get mixing. And don't forget to add the salt. Once the chicken is breaded, I moved it to a rack and let it sit for about 10 or 15 minutes before frying. Okay, more chicken.
So here we are once again, tasting chicken.
More chicken tests. So the color and the skin is all over the map this time.
Yes.
Whereas on the couple of the last ones that we've done, we've gotten very close to mimicking which is which. Now, we put the chicken on the plates, wrote on the bottom of the plate what it was, and then mixed it around. And at this point, I have a pretty good idea. Julie has no clue.
I have guesses, but that's...
So we've got five chickens in front of us. We're going to taste through them and then rank what we think of the skin, the flavor, overall.
Okay.
Which one do you want to start with?
How about that one?
Okay. It's tough work. I like this one. The color's not quite right, but I like it.
I'm kind of surprised at how crispy it is.
Mm-hmm. Last one.
Oh, I got this one. I think that one's the crispiest.
Yeah.
This one's this one. That one's pretty crispy, but that one's definitely crispiest.
Mm-hmm.
I think that one might be, to me, the most flavorful.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay. I would say this one is KFC.
Yeah, the color. Just based on the color. That one or this one based on color would be KFC, but this one didn't quite cut it for me.
Okay, so I think we both agreed this one is the least flavorful.
Yeah, I don't, and it's not very crunchy. It looks like it should be crunchy, like it's got all the visual for crispy chicken, but no, it's not.
So that's dipped in water and then put in the egg and the dried egg and the dried milk.
Okay, I think this one was the crispiest and one of my favorite, and I kind of went between these two as my favorite.
So, and I went between these two as my favorite. So, since we both chose this one as some form, this one was brined and then put in the egg wash.
Okay.
And then your favorite, you think?
I think so.
This was brined and then put in the water wash.
Okay.
And this was my favorite. And it was just the straight up egg wash.
There you go. So clearly I'm biased to the brined.
To the brined ones.
Flavor.
Now, I did really like this one that was brined. But it probably came in second for me. Egged and then brined and then put in the egg wash. So I think we're both leaning towards brined. Egg wash. If we had to conclude from that.
Our unscientific study of two.
Of two. So I think where I'm going to go from here is I'm going to do a couple of things in the background and go back to Dustin's recipe.
Okay.
That was really close. This was one that I sort of pulled in some other things. And then the next video that you see will be the one where you can do it at home in a pot in hot oil.
Okay.
You don't need the pressure fryer.
Just one more chicken video, right?
Okay. One more chicken video.
I will admit,
that's the end of the chicken video.
I'm almost done with chicken videos.
But I think that in this last little stretch here, we've had two or three really good recipes that are so close to KFC that you'd be, when you put them all out, you'd kind of like, which one's which?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
We're good. One more. Stay tuned. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.